Well, this is the new updated version of my ultimate work table, and I couldn't be happier with the way it turned out. You know, I'm not really a big fan of traditional side and tail vise work tables. For one thing, they require so much wood. They've got like four solid wood pieces of furniture worth of wood in them to make them work. And I just think that this is a better idea. I actually had a traditional workbench for a long time, but it was always just kind of a pain to just really get on with it. So you've seen in some of my other videos where I use my older version of this, but this is a new version I made just to make this video series, and I'm gonna really love having this in my shop. It's gonna take me a while to get it integrated into my workflow and to rearrange my small shop in here to get it together. And but so much of this was made with discount or salvage material, so I think that I probably don't even have $200 worth of material in this whole setup here. You know, maybe 250, but that's probably the upper limit. And that was mainly just to buy new plywood for the drawer bottoms, and you know, I got this baby blue laminate. It was discount laminate. It was discontinued, and part of it was cracked at my laminate supply place here in Austin, Travis Tile, as Wilson Art. But this thing just has a lot of incredible capabilities that just traditional tables don't have. You know, you have this perforated top, so it works like a Festool's multifunction table. So you know, you can use Festool's multifunction clamps. They work in all these different configurations to clamp work down in just about any configuration that you want. The clamps will come up through the table or down through the table like this. You know, that's why, and the other reason is when you have a giant 4-inch thick top, then clamping things to that top become more difficult. You need bigger, heavier clamps to be able to do that. But if you just have a 1.8 centimeter plywood top and it's supported with steel, it kind of negates the necessity of having all that, you know, those super heavy timbers. And so this is just really flexible. I can push this out of the way if I need to. You know, this is a great spot to put a board up here and cut without the blade being interfered with on top of your work table. And so I don't even bother attaching these tops to the structure because it's just so easy to clamp the top to the structure if I need to. So I just leave them like this. I mean, I thought about, you know, tapping into this and pinning it down, but that's just more trouble than it's worth. I mean, if I want to make sure that this isn't going to move, well, all I have to do is this, you know, and then work on the other end or put the clamps on the other end. And it's not going to go anywhere. But where I end up doing so much of my work is on these edges that overhang, because it's so easy to get a smaller clamp on to do some operation right here. So, you know, otherwise I'm trying to clamp, you know, what if I have a thicker piece and then I'm trying to clamp on another 4 inches of material. I just really like the way this works. And that's just the top. Now when you start thinking about the storage that this has with these giant flow-through drawers that are accessible from either side of the case for all your tools and things that you're working on right here where you're doing your work. And then this giant narrow tool drawer here for rulers and thinner things. And then you've got your giant drawers. You know, these are all these drawers are 5 feet long. That's what everything is based on. This Baltic birch plywood comes in 5x5. So, you know, this is big enough to have all your portable power tools right handy, where you're not having to reach inside to get them, or you know, you can pull these things out, they stay. You can come in here and organize your tools. Many times I've taken these entire drawers out, loaded them with stuff that I needed to take to a job site, and then just two people carry each end, throw it on my trailer in the back of my truck, and away I go to work. And then when I'm done at the end of the day, just come back, slide them back in my table, sort through things, put them back where they belong, and so they work pretty well. And this whole table can come apart, you know, it's all just bolted together. It's made with, not expensive materials. All this was salvage that I got from a friend, all these fir pieces. This is pine just from Home Depot. And then a lot of this stuff, even though this mahogany looks really good, this is leftover scrap from projects that I had worked on, and a lot of it has really bad checks or cracks in it that, you know, I wasn't able to work into furniture. But when you see me make this, and I cover every aspect of making this, I was so excited about this, the ledge that I produced, and I actually used it to cut the dovetails for the drawers, that as I was building this, I realized I can make something even better, and that's when I came up with these ledges here and kind of changed this up. So you'll see that this final version is different than what I made in the video. But I'm going to take what I had in the video and attach it to my old table. And then after I got this done, I wanted to come up with some type of clamping mechanism for the side that was simple and cheap. And I came up with these. I made these guys, and I completely show how to do this. For these two clamps, I don't think I have $5 in materials between the two of them. It's just based on all thread and a little bit of drilling and tapping and some 1-inch steel round bar stock. But basically what these are just half of hand screws. And so it was the inspiration was a hand screw, you know, which is one of the greatest woodworking tools ever. But I basically just made a half a hand screw and let the structure of the bench be the other half. And so whenever you're wanting to now work on the edge of a board or do some type of edge work, you just put your piece down in here, and this isn't even clamped because it has this solid ledge. No matter how far you extend this off, it's got this solid ledge to hold it and position it. And if you needed to move it up, you could just shim it with some, you know, you've seen all the little blocks that I use all the time. Well, that would be pretty easy. Now to clamp this, all I have to do is, you know, make sure that my jaws are in the right parallel arrangement, and that just lets this dial do that. But then once I have it, all I have to do is just give this guy a little crank, and that's not going anywhere. And I've got two of them. So, I mean, you talk about solid for chopping, cutting, routing, whatever you want to do, and simple, so simple that I was just so happy when this kind of, it took me a couple afternoons of puzzling some things out, you know, a few hours each afternoon when it was quiet and I wasn't doing anything to really come up with this. This has removable jaws in here too, so I can put different kinds of jaws in. They don't fall out. And check this out. So if you wanted to, they also pivot and will clamp at odd angles too. So I couldn't be happier. And like I said, I bet I don't even have, $5 may be stretching it between the two of these. But I show you completely how to do this in every way. And but I only added these to one side because I thought, you know, so shove your top out of the way and you're really not going to have access to the other side. Although I did put the ledges on both sides. I have the ledges on the other side, but I thought that I really only need the clamps on one side because, like I said, you know, the top would interfere with using it. But since I work by myself, I can only really manipulate one setup at a time anyway. So I may make it later, but I may not. And then if you don't want these in your way, they're really not in the way, so I probably will always leave them here because they're really not in the way. But if you said they are in the way, well, just by taking this out, unthreading this, Well, that just separates. Now this could just be stored in one of your drawers if you didn't need it. There's just a threaded piece of bar stock in here that this piece of all thread connects to. You can see all of these pivot for any angle and any relationship that you want to have, just like a hand screw. So I'm very, very happy with the way this all turned out. And you're going to, hopefully, I'm going to be making a lot more videos in the next few years, and you'll see this thing go from this pristine to, you know, hopefully it'll be covered with glue and stain and finish and pencil marks and stuff like my old dark blue table is. But yeah, I think I've got everything completely covered. And I also made this full-size drawing. So I think this was the most complicated portion of the table, was to make the sawhorses. And so I made this full-size drawing, and I go through every operation to make this table. I don't leave anything out. So I hope you enjoy it. And even if you don't build this table, I think there are so many very interesting operations, router, drill press, laminate work, metal work, that I think you could take some of these ideas and incorporate it into your own projects. Or maybe these will just be things that will spur you to think about problem solving that you would then like to share back with the rest of the woodworking community too. So, you know, a lot of times it just takes a spark from to see someone do something to then go, oh yeah, I'm gonna make a change in the way I work. That's why YouTube has been so fantastic, because we're able to share with one another and inspire one another to come up with different methods. Because many of us, like me, I work alone. I'll go days without talking to anybody other than my wife. And so we live these kind of insular lives often, you know, craftsmen and woodworkers. And so this has been a real great thing to be able to get out and interact with people all over the world and see other methods that people are using. And I guarantee you, I've learned things on YouTube that I'm already incorporating into my work. So, well, I hope you enjoy the series. It's long, but I think you're gonna. I hope you'll find it interesting. And so here we go.